The first of BepiColombo's 9 planetary flybys will be of Earth on April 10th. Since its launch almost 2 years ago, BepiColombo has been steadily making its long journey to Mercury, the innermost planet in our solar system. During this time, instruments have been checked and software updates installed. The trajectory has also been refined by firing its thruster and solar electric propulsion system. This is commanded and checked regularly from the ground. The spacecraft is deliberately travelling via a scenic route. The flybys put on the brakes, reduce its speed, and help obtain the correct final orbit around Mercury. This is how the Earth and Moon look from the spacecraft around 40 million kilometres away. During the first flyby, BepiColombo will take much closer images of the Earth and Moon, and a selfie or two, as it did shortly after launch, showing one of the unfurled solar arrays and two antennas. Within hours of the flyby, scientists will use the opportunity to calibrate the onboard ultraviolet spectrometer, PHEBUS, seen here having its pump disconnected from the orbiter on its way to the launch pad. They then have several days to make measurements and checks on some of the other instruments and sensors, with a nail-biting half hour when, due to its position with the Earth, there is no contact with the spacecraft. Regular spacecraft and instrument checks on its two orbiters from ESA and Japan will continue after the Earth flyby, with further software updates and fine-tuning. Mission scientists will also operate some of the instruments to monitor the solar wind and examine how the Sun interacts with the spacecraft. Although no science was originally planned during the journey, it was also discovered that the Mercury gamma ray and neutron spectrometer inside the European orbiter can detect gamma ray bursts, another added bonus. The main aim of the flyby, however, is to put on the brakes and decelerate the spacecraft into a closer orbit towards Venus, its next pit stop. BepiColombo will fly by Venus in October, with a second flyby around the planet in 2021. 6 further flybys will take place around Mercury before the spacecraft arrives in the planned orbit in December 2025, 7 years after launch.